I'm Samiha from Red Learner. I'm going to explain about what is health promotion. This is a definition for health promotion put forward by WHO. Process of enabling people to increase control over and to improve their health. It moves beyond a focus on individual behavior towards a wide range of social and environmental interventions. By this, we can clear that the health promotion is not only for the single individual, but also for an entire society. That means health promotions mean the environment should be free from diseases and disabilities and free from stress like that. Okay, let's move to the other slide. These are some of the strategies of health promotion. The first one is the formulate health promotion policies. Second one, obtain community participation for health promotion. Third one, develop skills required for health promotion. Fourth one, provision of required service for health promotion. And the fifth one, the last one is build a health promoting environment. Now we will explain briefly about this. We can convert some places as health promoting centers. Given below are some centers, we can convert them. First one is home, the second one is our school, the third one is our village, the fourth one is city, hospital and workplaces. Okay, now we can briefly explain about the actions to develop school health promotion. I have told the strategies of school health promotion. The first one is to formulate health promotion policies. By this, we can study that when we should formulate health promotion policies, first we must identify the current health issues and next we should reduce them. After that, when the policy is formulated, we can create a health promoting environment within our school environment. The given below are some school health promotion policies. The first one is provide adequate knowledge on health for students. In the government schools, the students must be provide health knowledge from grade 6 to grade 9. It is a must. The second one is provide clean drinking water. By this, we can identify that the school community must provide clean drinking water to the students in the canteen and the school environment also. Third one, provide hygienic canteens. We should provide healthy canteens. That means we should include nutritional, valid, and the healthy foods in the canteens. And the fourth one, providing accident-free environment. By this, we can conclude that we can provide an accident-free environment by reducing the accident causing things. The fifth one is to provide dental services for students. We can think that the PHI and some other public services are providing dental services for students in the school. That's a help for us. We should thank for them. And the sixth one is school books should be printed with different font sizes and colors as appropriate for each group. By this, we can conclude that the students are very likely to see these books when those books are in different font sizes and colors. Already the primary students are very likely for this. And the seventh one is provide appropriate height of desk and chairs. We can divide the age group as primary and secondary. For primary students, we should make desk and chairs a little bit short. And for secondary students, we should make the desk and chairs with little bit tall. That means we should make a desk with a drawer also. The last one is provide a proper waste management system. By this, we can conclude that we can provide above five also we can. We can provide different types of dustbins. Example, we can provide a dustbin separately for plastics, papers, like that. The given below the pictures are, you can note that the first one is a clean hygienic canteen. The second one is provide hygienic food in the school. That's why we are studying home science in the school. The next one, the second one is a build health promoting environment. By this, we can change our environment as health promoting environment. The environment which we are living also we can change. Below are some factors that should be present in our physical, mental and social environment to promote health in our environment. The first one is the physical environment. In the physical environment, we must provide clean drinking water. That means in the same idea I have told earlier, we should provide clean drinking water. We should drink even though the warm water also. The second one is provide adequate toilet facilities. We can provide one toilet. We can provide one toilet per 50 students, like that. Third one is provide classroom with adequate light and ventilation. We can provide we should provide classrooms with adequate light. That means we should provide classroom with adequate sunlight. Third one, proper waste management. Earlier I told that we should provide dustbins in different ways. The next one, school gardening. We also can conduct those school gardening activities. The school gardening activities, we can plant trees, we can conduct shramadana for cleaning and all. The next one, accident and danger-free environment. We can reduce the accident by reducing the accident-causing things. The next one is provide adequate sports facilities. We can take that for sports facilities, we should give enough sports equipments for them, for the students. By that, we can provide adequate sports facilities. The given two pictures are showing that the provide adequate sunlight and ventilation for classrooms. The next one is provide adequate sports facilities. The next one, mental environment. The first, in that one, students should not be insulted. That means the students should be very safeguard. That means they should not be involved in abuse and all. Next one, there should not be any form of abuse. The same thing. The third one, all students should be treated equally. That means the teachers should be treat all the students equally. And they must be tolerate all the views of the students. Next one, school environment should be free of stress. The school environment should not be give stress for students. The school environment should be very silent for the students to study. The next one, establish counseling services to students. The given below picture is also showing that we can provide counseling services for students in different ways by conducting camps and all. The next one, this is the picture showing the social environment. In that one, safeguard democracy. Second one, availability of space for group activities. In many of the schools, they have clubs for each subject. That means, example, we can take science club. For science club, we can take a science lab for enough space. In that science club, we can conduct many types of camps, activities, group activities, and all. By that, we can develop the healthy student-teacher relationships. Next one, spend leisure time meaningfully. We can conduct programs. Although we can conduct gardening activities and all, to spend leisure time. Next one, obtain community participation in health promotion. Ways in which the community can aid school health promotion are given below. We can gain community participation in different ways. The examples are given below. Parents and other members of community assists in the dengue eradication campaign conducted by the school. That means in these situations also, we can obtain the community participation. We can conclude that parents and the other members are as community. Next one, shramadana campaigns by members of the community to minimize accidents that can occur in the school premises. That means we should conduct shramadana campaigns per a month. Next one, construct a sports ground in school. By that, we can develop our physical endurance. Next one, reduce cigarette sales outlets around the school to prevent students from being introduced to smoking. By this, we can produce a good, that means we can build up a good future generation by reducing the cigarette sales in the school premises. Next one, develop skills required for health promotion. Developing skills such as consume healthy meals, doing exercises, and face challenges successfully are essential for health promotion. Skills can be developed by providing knowledge through books and educational workshops, group competitions, debates, and sports competitions. For example, we can take good decision making. For this good decision making, select healthy food from what is available in the market. Second one, effective communication. We can communicate with teachers, students, between teachers, students, between teachers, principals, and etc. By this, we can understand the things implied in the advertisements correctly. The next one, provision of required services for health promotion. School students are provided with iron and folic acid tablets to improve their health status. Not only that, the PHI, PHM, and MOH are carrying out dental services, immunization programs, counselings, and all. They are helping us in different ways. Example, the PHI carries out an annual school sanitary survey in the areas that can give rise to illness or accidents are identified and measures taken to prevent them. Correcting the shortcomings in the public health services is also a health promotion. We can take the correcting the shortcomings in the public health services as a health promotion also. Okay. Next one. Criteria for school health promotion evaluation. Given below are some criteria included in the school health promotion circular of Ministry of Education to improve health promotion activities in school. The school accepting the need to follow established health policies. The second one, recognition of health policies that can be carried out by the school. We can accept the health policies that is carried out by the school. Third one, identifying methods of carrying out these health policies. That means, for example, we can take a health policy as management. For that, we should second one, provide one toilet per 50 students. That is a centered facility. Third one, create an accident-free environment. Fourth one, carry out dengue eradication programs. For this, we can conduct shutdown campaigns also. The third law is prohibit the consumption or sale of unhealthy food. For this, we can maintain a healthy canteen. That means we can give rise to that means we can give porridge and all like that healthy foods. Fourth law is prohibit the possession or use of drugs. That means we should avoid the use of cigarettes in the school. For by this, we can build up a good future generation. This is a video shown about for the health promotion. This is in Sinhala. However, I will explain. In this video, the man is advising that is it's mean it is showing that it's a counseling program like that. This man is counseling the schools too. This video is short for that. Thank you for all the people who are on behalf of my presentation. Thank you, everybody.